So what I want to do here is have a discussion about Batman Beyond. And what I'm hoping is that at the end of this video, you'll have a strong understanding of the character, as well as why fans are looking forward to the return of Terry McGinnis and the post-DC Rebirth continuity. So much like Harley Quinn, Terry McGinnis and the Batman Beyond concept debuted as part of DC's animated universe in 1999, and were created by Bruce Timm, Paul Dini, and Alan Burnett. During a 2001 interview with Tomorrow's Publishing, a publisher of magazines and comics founded in 1994 and specializing in the history of the comic industry, Bruce Timm stated that with 1994's Batman the Animated Series receiving universal acclaim and considered to be one of the best animated series ever created, in 1997, DC had produced a relaunch in the form of the New Batman Adventures. To sidetrack here, for those of you who never saw the original Batman the Animated Series, because the 1987 Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and 1992 X-Men cartoon shows had reinvigorated interest in creating animated content, this was beginning to lose interest from 6 to 11 year old demographic yet again. As a result, Bruce Timm was contacted to create a teenage version of Bruce Wayne, who could tap into Warner Brothers' target age group by making the hero more relatable as a teenager. While Timm, Dini, and Burnett were not initially on board with the idea due to the desire to keep the continuity the same, after taking a weekend to brainstorm ideas, the trio came up with the idea to provide a spin-off series which combined the dystopian future of The Dark Knight Returns with science fiction, both of which could come together to create a whole new brand while maintaining the roots of what made the animated Batman franchise so great. Pitching the idea to the president of Warner Brothers, the concept was immediately accepted and a blank check was issued, allowing Timm, Dini, and Burnett to finish out the 10 remaining episodes of Batman Superman Adventures before canceling the series and starting work on Batman Beyond. Centering on Terry McGinnis, Batman Beyond saw a wholesale removal of most of Bruce Wayne's most prominent friends, enemies, and allies, with Alfred Pennyworth, Lucius Fox, Commissioner James Gordon, Nightwing, Batgirl, Catwoman, and Tim Drake either dying of natural causes, abandoning Bruce Wayne, or simply moving on. In addition to this, the most famous members of Batman's rogues gallery, including the Joker, Harley Quinn, Penguin, Two-Face, Poison Ivy, and others, were removed as well, although no real information was forthcoming on where they had gone, aside from their presumed incarcerations or deaths. Now, where the pilot episode established these principles and Bruce Wayne facing forced retirement due to his age making him unable to fight crime accurately, the series jumped forward 20 years to the life of Terry McGinnis, carrying on Batman's mantle under the watchful eye of Bruce Wayne. Taking a page out of the original Batman cartoon series, under Dini, Timm, and Burnett, a slow rollout of Terry's life unfolded, growing to depict him living within Gotham, which had become a megacity immersed in crime due to Bruce's inactivity for the last 20 years, as well as groups like the Joker's Gang modeling themselves after the iconic villain and overpowering police. Furthermore, because Batman's origin is setting in a household story, the problem faced by Dini, Timm, and Burnett was providing a means for Terry to undertake the mantle without appearing to recreate the age-old tale. To this end, Terry was shown to have a strained relationship with his father, Warren McGinnis, while harboring a bit of an anti-hero streak and a strong sense of justice. Encountering Bruce Wayne for the first time in the series by engaging in a high-speed chase with the Jokers after the gang had harassed Terry and his girlfriend Dana, where Terry and Bruce saw the gang off together, following this short battle, Terry had discovered the entrance to the Batcave, leading him to realize that Bruce and Batman were one and the same. A slow rollout of Terry's life unfolded, growing to depict him living within Gotham, which had become a megacity immersed in crime due to Bruce's inactivity for the last 20 years, as well as groups like the Joker's Gang modeling themselves after the iconic villain and overpowering police. Furthermore, because Batman's origin is setting in a household story, the problem faced by Dini, Timm, and Burnett was providing a means for Terry to undertake the mantle without appearing to recreate the age-old tale. To this end, Terry was shown to have a strained relationship with his father, Warren McGinnis, while harboring a bit of an anti-hero streak and a strong sense of justice. Encountering Bruce Wayne for the first time in the series by engaging in a high-speed chase with the Jokers after the gang had harassed Terry and his girlfriend Dana, where Terry and Bruce saw the gang off together, following this short battle, Terry had discovered the entrance to the Batcave, leading him to realize that Bruce and Batman were one and the same. While the discovery did earn Terry the ire of Bruce, who passed him out of the cave and forbid his return, Terry's steps to undertake the Batman mantle came when his father had been killed under the orders of Derek Powers, a corrupt businessman who had merged Powers Industries with Wayne Enterprises to form the Wayne Powers Corporation and began usurping control of the company in the face of Bruce's failing health. Appealing to Bruce's own experience in losing a parent, Terry took on a more technologically advanced variant of the Batsuit, and after doing battle with Powers, who was exposed to a radioactive chemical in the process, Powers went on to become Terry's arch-nemesis, while Terry himself sought to eliminate the corruption which had seized control of Gotham. Now following this pilot episode and going into the main series itself, Batman Beyond actually had a bit of a slow start. The reason for this was due to the fact that prospective viewers were essentially jumping into the extreme variant of the Batman character. With Batman the Animated Series, the reason the show saw its massive popularity was due to the fact that virtually all the characters contained within were established and recognizable. Whether it be the Joker, the Penguin, Two-Face, Commissioner Gordon, Dick Grayson, or even Bruce himself, The television series was predicated on over 50 years worth of stories. However, by casting aside all established concepts and walking into something wholly new, prospective viewers were essentially asked to walk away from everything that made Batman the animated series so great and try something new. Seeing their gamble pay off, as the Batman Beyond series began to focus on Terry's relationship with his girlfriend Dana, the strain that came with Terry living a double life, as well as the various high school problems he experienced, many of the show's viewers were able to identify and live vicariously through Terry and being the next generation of one of DC's most iconic heroes, and their viewers themselves faced their own high school struggles and issues of balancing their romantic lives and personal lives. Furthermore, because the goal of Dini and Timm was to make Terry his own hero, his enemies and allies kept the roots of the original Batman villains, but were updated for the new audience, with villains like the shape-shifting Ink standing in for Clayface, along with the Royal Flash Gang, Mr. Freeze, and Ra's al Ghul returning to the landscape alongside Barbara Gordon as a new police commissioner. The Batman Beyond series grew to become nearly as popular as the original Batman series, and that newer and younger fans now had a Batman of their own to enjoy and grow attached to. This experience was bolstered by the fact that with the Superman animated series continuing to run strong since its launch, DC quite literally took over the world of animated adaptations to comic-related content. Furthermore, while Batman Beyond didn't immediately see a crossover with the rest of DC's offerings at the time, in Season 3, Terry was given his own team-up with a futuristic version of the Justice League, whose popularity was used by Bruce Timm to initiate the launch of the Justice League TV show in 2001. Now having said all that, the first comic book appearance of Terry McGinnis within DC came with a six-part miniseries, Batman Beyond. Released in March of 1999 as a monthly series and written by Hilary J. Bader, the miniseries was more of a comic book retelling of Terry's first encounter with the various members of his rogues gallery, including Derek Powers' henchmen Mr. Fix, Ink, Alexano, and others. With the last issue of the six-part series ending in September, a second volume was launched in October of 1999, with Hilary Bader returning as writer. Running for 24 issues and continuing to remain a monthly series, unlike the miniseries, Volume 2 functioned to expand on the Batman Beyond universe while remaining isolated from the main DC continuity. In a 2003 interview with Shannon Muir of Sweet101.com, a website that no longer functions but previously focused on blog posts relating to the fledgling geek culture movement, Bader had stated that as someone best known for being a contributing writer to Star Trek The Next Generation, Star Trek Voyager, and Deep Space Nine, while she was familiar with the issue of deadlines, the problem she faced was that the comics could not move ahead of the actual series itself. In order to keep this from happening, Volume 2 found itself suffering from lashes and wanes, as some comics were forced into multiple parts, or existing plot threads were simply left hanging, with the series being cancelled in 2001. Now before we go any further, something that I want to do here is take a second and talk about Terry's relationship to Bruce. By this point in the history of DC Comics and the DC animated universe, it's common knowledge among readers that Terry McGinnis was the biological son of Bruce Wayne. Now the reason I say was, is that this idea was not established until the final episode of Justice League Unlimited, which was really more of an unofficial ending than an official ending. And because Bruce had never produced a child of his own, Amanda Waller, a fan favorite character similar to Nick Fury from Marvel Comics, had reasoned that with Bruce growing older and unable to remain Batman for the long haul, steps would need to be taken to ensure his legacy continued. Injecting Terry's father with a nanotech solution that rebroke his genetic material, to anyone who tested Terry's blood, his DNA was composed of Mary McGinnis and Bruce Wayne. Now in truth, this bit of information was a surprise to some, but only small, in that it seemed a natural progression to have Terry become the son of Bruce. The reason for this was that as a man who had emotionally distanced himself from the rest of the world, it seemed strange that he would suddenly turncoat and become a father figure to a boy he hardly knew. The downside to this revelation was that it came as a throw-in to wrap up the cancelled series, and never allowed Timm, Dini, or Burnett to flesh out the characters any further. Now the reason why I brought up this discussion on Terry's heritage is that while his comic book appearances ended with the end of Batman Beyond Volume 2, when DC initiated their long-wide reboot in 2011 with the New 52, Terry McGinnis was brought back under the Batman Beyond brand under the writing of Adam Beechin, who had also drawn the series with contributions from Ryan Benjamin. Covered in a March 2010 blog by DC's editorial team, because the New 52 was designed to bring in new readers who felt alienated by the massive backlog of DC-related content and the knowledge necessary to understand everything that was going on, with different creators being offered the opportunity to revamp or reintroduce existing and previously canceled publications. To this end, Beechin was approached by DC co-publisher Dan DiDio with the purpose of testing the waters to see if an interest remained in seeing Terry McGinnis return to the DC comic landscape. Appearing within the pages of Superman Batman Annual No. 4 in the story A Time Beyond Hope from August 2010, exactly 1 year before the launch of the New 52, because the Superman Batman line of comics allowed for one-shots and multi-part stories dealing with the escapades of Bruce Wayne and Clark outside of the official DC timeline, the appearance of Terry acting as Batman in the story allowed DC to experiment with fan reception without committing to an ongoing series at the start of the New 52. Written by Paul Levitz, the story took a more adult-oriented standpoint than previous Batman Beyond comics by having Lex Luthor seize control of Metropolis, infecting the city's citizens with kryptonite and keeping Superman away. Centering on Terry McGinnis investigating Lightoff and was experiencing a sudden influx of criminals from Metropolis, the story revealed that despite being unable to remain in the city for any length of time, Superman had been jumping in and out too fast to be seen, but imprisoning various criminals within the Phantom Zone. Coming together alongside Clark in his efforts to track down and defeat Luthor, once Lex was imprisoned in the Phantom Zone for eternity, Superman departed Earth, leaving Terry behind to act as jailer for those trapped in the Phantom Zone. Now, using this as a jumping off platform due to fans being excited to see Terry return, even if only for the sake of nostalgia, in the next 2 weeks under writer Adam Beechin, DC launched Batman Beyond Volume 3 as a 6-part miniseries. While the overarching villain of the miniseries was revealed to be Hush, an enemy of Bruce Wayne who had escaped imprisonment and sought to kill Bruce, the purpose behind the miniseries was to actually retcon the relationship between Terry and Bruce by removing the storyline of Amanda Waller altering the DNA of Terry's biological father Warren. While fans didn't object to this due to the fact that the plotline seemed to have been something the series didn't need anyway, when the New 52 was officially launched in August of 2011, DC maintained the idea of Terry being an adoptive son of Bruce instead of biological. However, the success of the Batman Beyond line under Adam Beechin was extremely short-lived, and that the title only lasted 8 issues before it being cancelled due to poor sales, where some contributed this to the inconsistent art and others pointed to the idea that Batman Beyond was not actually as popular as fans made it out to be. The series was rolled over into a digital-only line of comics and expanded to include Justice League Beyond and Superman Beyond, creating a universe separate from the main New 52 continuity similar to the Injustice series. While the move allowed DC to save money on distribution and release more comics on a longer timescale, the titles continued to prove unsuccessful, with Superman Beyond, Justice League Beyond, and Batman Beyond all being cancelled in June of 2013. Now following this and viewing the title's failure as being due to the fact that the Batman Beyond related titles had existed outside of the New 52, in May of 2014, under writers Brian Azzarello, Jeff Lemire, Dan Jurgens, and Keith Giffen, DC initiated the 10-part story Futures End as a way to roll Batman Beyond over into the New 52 continuity, with Terry McGinnis slated to be replaced by Tim Drake, as well as lead into the events of Convergence. Taking place 35 years in the future and centering on the transformation of Earth's heroes into cyborgs by Brother Eye, a sentient satellite developed in part by Bruce Wayne and designed to monitor superhero activity, Terry McGinnis had jumped into the past in an effort to halt the development of Brother Eye and prevent the conversion of humans to cyborgs. Arriving 5 years later than he intended to, because the conversion process was already underway, the remainder of the story saw Terry McGinnis teaming up with Tim Drake to defeat Brother Eye before the conversion of heroes to cyborgs could continue. Because the conclusion of the story saw Terry McGinnis dying, in June of 2015, the series was relaunched as Volume 6 under the writing of Dan Jurgens. Placing Tim Drake in the title role and Dick Grayson replacing Bruce Wayne, in truth, the change-up left the Batman Beyond community split. Where older fans wanted to see Terry McGinnis return since he was viewed as the definitive version of the character, since he was the only one to ever operate as Batman Beyond up until the relaunch, newer fans were growing tired of seeing DC rebranding the New 52 as a new era of comics while holding on to old ideologies. During an interview with DCComics.com prior to the series release, writer Dan Jurgens had stated that Futures End could best be summed up as establishing Terry McGinnis as someone who existed in the future of the New 52 continuity, with the series ending with Terry being replaced by Tim Drake. While the new Batman Beyond would remain as part of the New 52, because it took place in the future of the continuity, the problem faced by fans was that there should have been some reference to present events within the pages of the Batman Beyond comics. The fact that this did not happen left readers feeling the series was part of the New 52 in name only, something that was compounded on following the events of Convergence, going into DCU as the mantra of story over continuity. So with executive editor Jeff Johns of DC announcing the DC Rebirth event during WonderCon of 2016, it was officially announced that the Batman Beyond line would be relaunched and see the return of Terry McGinnis. Now for those of you who are unfamiliar with DC Rebirth or have not been keeping up with the news as it's been released, one of the biggest criticisms of the New 52 was that it completely wiped away decades of character development for the sake of providing a fresh starting off point. While DC itself had been tight-lipped about admitting this issue or acknowledging its legitimacy, in the face of Marvel's Secret Wars event, the launch of the Marvel Prime Universe, and declining sales, DC announced Rebirth as a way to reset some of their characters and teams to their pre-New 52 status in the hopes of having a best-of-both worlds continuity. While most of these changes won't be clearly known until the Rebirth event actually starts in June of 2016, questions reign among fans as to how Terry will return, despite having died, at the conclusion of Futures End. With that being said, we're going to bring this video to an end, and let me know how you guys feel about Batman Beyond. Do you love him? Do you not really care? I'm kind of curious. And we'll catch you guys later. Peace.